Good afternoon. Support position in minimal access surgery. In this presentation, we will discuss access technique first, and after that, the port position. Because putting the correct port is very important in laparoscopy, already you know that. And one of the most common question which comes in our mind whenever we start any laparoscopic surgery is that where should I put my port? And even if you do the laparoscopy, you are expert in laparoscopy, then also it comes in the mind in every patient. Because all the patients may not be of same pathology. It may be bigger cyst, smaller cyst, bigger uterus, smaller uterus, cirrhosis of liver, retrocecal appendix, moderate size splenomegaly. So this problem is recurrent problem. And many a time we learn from our mistake. Once we do the mistake, we struggle, and next time we say that, no, I will do something and I will put some other port. And that way we try to perform the surgery. So the statistical data has shown that most common cause of wrong port position is that you have the bad planning, development, ideas are wrong, strategy is wrong, and your ultimately goal is wrong. You will not achieve the goal. So what is there? It will be more expensive and more time taking. If your wrong port position is there, your cost of surgery increases. One is anesthesia cost, another is OT cost. And you need to use expensive instrument. You need endo-GI linear staplers. You need the advanced energy sources. And it will be more time taking also. So that's why it is important to know the correct port position. Primary port, that is also called as optical port, there are six sites of the primary optical port. One is supraumbilical, another is infraumbilical, third is superior crease of umbilicus, fourth is inferior crease of umbilicus. Fifth is transumbilical. And the sixth is Palmer's point. These are the six sites of the primary optical port. That is blind port, because we don't have telescope right now. So this is optical port. Whenever you perform any upper abdominal surgery, like if you do fundoplication, hiatus hernia, sleeve gastrectomy, you should put supraumbilical port. This is supraumbilical. Supraumbilical port may be of two types. You have to recognize it. If patient is normal, not obese, then it can be 5 cm above the umbilicus. And if patient is obese, it should be how much? 22.5 cm below the GP sternum. This is 22.5 cm below the GP sternum. Why? Because yes, umbilicus is sagged down. It is sagged down. And why 22.5? Half of the length of the instrument is 45. So this is supraumbilical port. Now if you have any deep lower pelvic surgery, like suppose you have presacral neurectomy, Luna, or very deep pelvic lymph node dissection, and it is a very common port position for gynecologists who do single puncture sterilization. Single puncture sterilization by blind trocar insertion. In the villages or in the camps in India, you might have seen, they give infraumbilical, that is 3 to 5 cm below the umbilicus. It is here. Now, over the umbilicus, there are three sites. One is superior crease of umbilicus. That is called as crying incision. This is crying incision. Other is inferior creature form like this. That is called as smiling. And third is transumbilical. Transumbilical means with the base of the umbilicus. This is transumbilical. And this is a smiling incision. So, among all these three, crying, smiling, and trance, we have to decide one. And the last is Palmer's point. So I am going to demonstrate you a little bit about this crying incision, a smiling incision, and transumbilical incision. Let us assume that this is the abdominal wall of the patient, this is umbilicus, this is upper abdominal wall, and this is the umbilicus area. Now after that, we have the anterior rectus. This is anterior rectus and this is posterior rectus. Posterior rectus is deficient from here. It is only up to the arcuate line and these are the muscles. These are the muscle fibers. This is pubic symphysis bone. This is pubic symphysis bone. And then lastly you have the peritoneum. This is the peritoneum. Now here is one vitellointestinal duct. Do you know this vitellointestinal duct is present in fetal life, which was communicating the small intestine of the baby with the umbilical cord of mother. Isn't it? And after third week, after in third trimester, it gets disconnected. It is now disconnected. But this vitelointestinal tract, this is also called as umbilical tube, is present in everyone. We have this. Just you need to dilate it. And once you dilate it, it will open and you can put the trocar inside. The cell intelligence of this area has a spontaneous capacity of closure. Do you know God has given the intelligence of each cell of our body? A skin knows how to behave. Mucosa knows how to behave. Isn't it? So this cell intelligence of this vitellointestinal tract has a beautiful, if you put a trocar through this area, and once you enter, after that, once you remove your trocar, it will spontaneously close. And you have an extremely rare chance of developing hernia. This idea was given first time by the Scandinavian surgeon. So it is called as a Scandinavian technique. A Scandinavian technique is a technique of entering into the abdominal cavity through the lower crease of the umbilicus and dilating the obliterated vitellointestinal tract with a Kelly's clamp or mosquito forceps and then introducing trocar pointing towards the anus. If you will go through the umbilicus, this is the thinnest part of abdominal wall and this is dirty also. The base of the umbilicus is thinnest part. And it has a high load of Streptococcus epidermis bacteria. That bacteria is not very good for our body and it may create weeping umbilicus. Patient may complain after many months also that once we go to the shower and press it, some fluid coming out. And it has a more tendency to developing the umbilical sinuses, umbilical hernia and other infection. If you go to the inferior crease of umbilicus, these problems will not be there. If you have used it only for telescoping, you have not used it for tissue retrieval, then you don't need to close the port. Remember, all the port which is of 5 mm size, you don't need to close. Incidence of hernia is 0.25%. Means 1 in 400 patients may come with the hernia If 5 millimeter port, you will not close. If you will not close 10 millimeter port, hernia is 0.5 to 2%. 2 in 100% next year will come with the hernia to get it repaired free. Because you will say, this is your created hernia. I don't know how it happened. If it is 12 mm, then it is 5 to 10%. And if it is 15 mm, it is 20%. So if you see, it is quadrupled. With a bigger incision, 15 mm means morcellated. 12 mm means endogial linear stapler. Isn't it? 12 mm trocar. Or sometimes 12 mm means you have used the endo bag and pulling it out or extracting the tissue forcefully. Wound is dilated and you have to repair it, otherwise you are in trouble. So among all these sites, the best site is what? Inferior crease of humilitis. This is important to remember. So we were going to this point and we were seeing all the port site, and among all the port sites, the best site is inferior crease of humilitis. So let us go with this, all the site again, that is supraumbilical. Supraumbilical means not superior crease. Please keep in mind, supraumbilical means not superior crease. It is 5 cm above the humilitis. Infraumbilicus means not inferior crease. It is 5 cm below the. Over the umbilicus, superior crease means crying incision. It makes a shape of a crying face. Inferior crease means a smiling incision. It makes a shape of a smiling face. And transumbilical is base of the umbilicus. And Palmer's point is mid-clavicular line just below the costal margin. So here we have these all the ports. This is for supraumbilical, for hiatus hernia, for fundoplication. This is the port position. And midline always, not go to the lateral. For deep pelvic surgery, infraumbilical, tubal sterilization, infraumbilical. This is 3 to 5 centimeter below the umbilicus. And over the umbilicus, three sides. This is base of the umbilicus. You can see a skin is so confluent that always better to go superior crease. That is crying incision. Transumbilical, over the base of the umbilicus. It is used by some of the surgeons, especially in obese patients, they find it easy to enter through the base of the umbilicus. And this is crying incision that will go to the Scandinavian technique through the inferior crease of umbilicus. Now this is Palmer's point. Here it is mid-clavicular line just below the costal margin. Palmer's point is the most attractive site of the primary trocar insertion whenever umbilicus is diseased. What are the advantages of Palmer's point? We have discussed before that this is the only part of the abdominal cavity where adhesion is extremely rare, because the stomach is so muscular, keep on distending, deflating. Second advantage, this is the only part of hollow viscous which can be deflated just by putting one nasogastric tube. You cannot deflate hepatic flexor. You cannot deflate sigmoid colon, but you can deflate the stomach. Third advantage, costal margin here keep the abdominal wall lifted up from the stomach. Fourth advantage is stomach is a good organ to perforate. Why I am telling you, that's why the surgeons are doing transgastric cholecystectomy or transgastric, because it is a good organ to perforate. It can only create chemical peritonitis, which you can stop by putting a proton pump inhibitor. It will not create bacterial peritonitis, and you can suture it full thickness also. It has an oblique layer of the muscle. If the venous needle puncture also, it doesn't have consequences. Spontaneously it will heal. You should not puncture with the trocar. Various needle, and you know, deflated stomach is very difficult to puncture, because rise tube is must, nasogastric tube is must if you are using Palmer point. And one of the contraindication is splenomegaly. Splenomegaly should never ever be there, otherwise it may be dangerous. So these are the two things which you should must take care. After that you can use Palmer's point. Now Inferior crease of umbilicus is one of the safest part for entering inside. Why? Why inferior crease? Because it is central location, less swarding and easy access. Central location. Do you know? Optical trocar. Whenever you have to, suppose you have to put one light. Suppose you have to put one light in your mosque or in your temple. Where you will try to put it? On the center. And then less swarding. It doesn't create swarding with the other secondary ports. Because the central location, so other ports, other working needle holder, seizures, it will not do swarding. And easy access. Why? Because it doesn't have significant blood vessels and thin part of abdominal wall. So easy access. Second advantage is less chances of hernia. Because center of gravity, umbilical tube and valve action and confluence skin. Center of gravity, umbilical tube, already we have discussed that it has a vitreo-intestinal duct. That is umbilical tube, valve action, because this umbilical tube, as soon as your trocar is out, will collapse like a valve. And confluence skin means circular skin. What is the advantage of confluence skin? I will show you. Advantage of confluence skin is that sometime it is used even for single incision laparoscopy. Let us see, I will show you, that suppose this is umbilicus. And if you give a smiling incision, this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, this way, and here you give an incision like that. Do you know what is the size of incision? 20 mm. Even a seal port can introduce. But if you see the width of the incision is how much? 10 mm. Like this. Isn't it? If we give an incision like that, then once you expand it, it becomes that much. This is how much? 20 mm. And once your job is over, it becomes again this way. So actually it is 10 mm. You got the point? So even in single incision laparoscopic surgery, when you have to put the port, this is very useful. And it is attractive. So this is actually 10 mm, but functionally 20 mm. That property you are getting because of confluence skin. This is advantage. Next advantage is less infection. Why less infection? Because it has no bacterial flora and dry surface. Base of the umbilicus has an umbilical flora. Umbilical is a dirty cavity. When you take a shower, all of you must be taking care of cleaning the umbilicus. Isn't it? Must be putting some shampoo to clean. If you are not doing it, do it next time. You should clean it. So this is good and dry surface. You know, base of the umbilicus is wet surface because sweat gets deposited there. And as you know, for any infection to propagate, the moisture and bacteria is responsible. Inferior crease of umbilicus is relatively dry. So that's why people, they say, if you give a smiling incision, you will keep on smiling. Some people, they give vertical incision here. You might have seen some people in the inferior crease of umbilicus, they go and they give vertical incision. Vertical incision like this. Have you seen that? This way. This is also not bad. It is good. But you need an ornament to hide it, isn't it? Because it will be visible. A smiling won't be visible. It will hide in the curvature of the confluence skin. So this is the advantage over the longitudinal. Longitudinal will be visible. Someone will say that, is there any surgery? But in the smiling, nobody can see that any surgery was performed. Now, before starting the access, you should check the varus needle. And various needles should be checked for a spring action and patency test. Here the saline, you will blow the saline and patency test and a spring action. This is important, especially if you are using reusable. Yesterday you might have seen this was disposable, they have used couple of times and might have dropped somewhere. Tip was blunt, it didn't go. So I have to change the various needle. And blunt various needle or blunt trocar is more risky because abruptly you will enter. After that, hold it properly, like a dart. Three finger, pulp of three finger and thumb should oppose each other. And it should be naked how much? 4 plus thickness of abdominal wall. Then you will take 2 Allies forceps either side to evert the crease of humilicus. So here this is the crease of humilicus. Here is the crease of humilicus, this one, this is the crease. Purpose of Allies forceps is so that humilicus will stand up and the crease will be visible. Once the crease is visible, after that you just give one a small stab wound and put the various needle in the skin first. And once it has gone to the skin, then leave the Allies forceps and lift the abdominal wall. Don't use Allies forceps to lift the abdominal wall. It won't be possible. It will slip. And you don't have to lift the abdominal wall at the level of umbilicus. You have to lift the abdominal wall below the umbilicus. Another precaution is, don't lift it, suppose this is the umbilicus, don't lift it just below the umbilicus. It will make a fold of rectus and your needle will go into the rectus. It should be halfway below suprapubic area you should lift. This is important. I will show you in the video also later. So this is, and then you point the various needle towards the anus. If you see here, angle between the, this is various needle going, angle between the various needle and the abdominal wall should be 90 degree. And this angle should be 45 degrees. And then you will get 2 click sound. And this is how you will lift. You should always lift with the thenar eminence and all the 4 fingers. If you feel, because we have to do by left hand, if you feel little difficulty, ask your male assistant, especially ladies, if they cannot lift it, male assistant to lift it and help them to lift either side. After that, you point it towards the anus, and you will enter. After once you have get 2 click sound, then you do irrigation test. Put some saline and put it inside. This is irrigation. After that, you suck it back. Nothing should come back. We can see some air is there. If air is there, it is good. First suction should not be done. This is important. Do you know? Various needle is like a pistol. Have you seen the pistol? In the pistol, the opening is on the side. And when you fire the pistol, bullet jacket is coming out from the side. Once it moves like that, it discharges. Same way, eye of the various needle is on the side. Eye of the various needle is never on the tip. So once the spring action of the various needle goes, it pulls some fat. Always. So that's why irrigation should be done first. So it will wash out the all the trapped tissue into the side eye of the various needle. Otherwise, what you do? When you put simple needle in the muscle, first you suck. So that there should not be any vein or blood vessel. Your nurses are first sucking and then irrigating. But here you should irrigate first. Because eye is not at the tip, it is on the side. And then nothing should come back. After that, you just put few drop of saline here. And this saline should be sucked in. If it is not sucking it, pull the saline and then lift the abdominal wall. Once you lift the abdominal wall, it will be sucked. After that, attach the tubing of insufflator and start oblique hold with the various needle. And careful insufflation. And remember, insufflation initially should be 1 liter per minute. And initially up to 100 ml, always keep oblique hold. Means don't leave it unattended. If you leave it unattended, the eye of the variation will touch some omentum or bowel, and your insufflator will start giving you alarm. Alarm of occlusion. And it may damage also somewhere. So careful oblique hold. After 1 liter you may leave it. Because already a space is created in between the bowel and the abdominal wall. But initially in the beginning there is no space. So tip of the various needle might be touching the omentum or bowel. And then you will start seeing the insufflator. What you will see over the insufflator? Only 2 things. One is actual pressure. Another is total amount of gas used. And initially, within 5 seconds, actual pressure should go to single digit. Initially, maybe for first second, it may be high. But within 5 seconds, it goes single digit. Single digit means 4, 5, 6. If it is going within 5 seconds, it go to double digit, like 12 or 15, that means you are in prepatory. And if it is single digit, you should be, after 100 to 200 ml, see the obliteration of the liver damage. And then again, see, within 400-500 ml, it should go 3-5. Now you are happy. After 500 ml, you can leave the veracinil and then you can talk with your nurse. But initially, within 200-300 ml, you should be very carefully watching the all the meters of the insufflator. Because this is a time to talk with the insufflator. An insufflator will tell you where it is going, overpressure, occlusion, isn't it? Flow rate and total amount of gas used. So this is called quadromanometric indicator. So what are the steps of the optical trocar entry? Confirm pneumoperitoneum by quadromanometric indicator. Quadro means four, manometric indicator. Four means preset pressure, actual pressure, flow rate and total amount of gas used. After that, extend the incision to 11 mm. This is very important. And sometimes we do this mistake. This should not be there. What happened? That sometime our trocar and cannula is there, and our incision is less. And then incision is 9 mm. And then you are holding it like that, and then you are putting it, and you are tightening it this way. And then it doesn't go. You know why? Margins of the skin will get inverted. If your incision is 9 mm and your trocar is pushing it hard, the margin of the cut skin get inverted like that. And dry inverted skin make a so tight hold over your cannula that it is impossible to go. And suddenly you go abrupt entry. So remember, first incision should always be 11 mm. This is 11 mm or more. If you have a problem in finding out the 11 mm, suppose in the beginning, because if it is 15 mm, then there is a problem. What is the problem? Gas will leak. If it is 9 mm, then also there is a problem. Then what you do? You take the one cannula, and over, this is inferior crease of umbilicus, you go with the cannula alone without trocar and do like that. See, there will be impression. Can you see the impression here? This is the impression. And cut inferior crease over this impression. So this is the measurement. If you will cut it over that, it will be 11 mm. Because outer diameter of the cannula is 11 mm. So if you have a little problem with the thinking that it may be 13 or it may be 9, then you can give impression by the tip of the cannula, so that it will make exactly identical 11 mm. And then aspirate the fatty tissue by Kelly clamp. This is the way how you should make a fatty tissue. And just open like a bird which digs the tree. And direction should be caudally going to open the obliterated vitreo-intestinal tract. The time which you spend it is very important to enter it safely. And you are actually dilating the obliterated vitreo-intestinal tract, that is called as a Scandinavian technique. And after that, you hold the trocar like a pistol. And then stabilize the abdominal wall and then point it. By a screwing movement, you should not push it. Give the pressure less, rotation more. Less pressure, more rotatory movement. And then slowly you will enter inside. So, in different scenario, different type, so let us start with simple pediatric case, and after that we will discuss the obese case and then other cases, how to do. This is a pediatric patient, so you will take 2 L's forceps and put it either side, then you take a 11 number of knife and just give a small stab wound over the inferior crease. After that, measure the thickness of abdominal wall. It is 2 cm. Add 2 plus 4, that is 6. and guard the vares needle. So only 6 centimeter of the vares needle shaft should be naked, and vares needle already suction and patency is checked. After that, you put the tip of the vares needle in this skin wound, and then lift the abdominal wall. Here, this is important. It should be this way. So down it should be. It should not here. It should be below the halfway. And then this angle is 90, this is 45. That much lifting of abdominal wall is required. And then here one click, and then second click. If you are using the disposable, you will see color also changes here. Become red, green, red, green. That will be visible. If it is red, that means you are not in. If it is green, that means you are in. After that, hold the vares needle and do the irrigation test. This is irrigation. Suction, nothing came, only air bubble. And suction will create further negative pressure. Isn't it? Negative pressure if you are in cavity. And normally there is a negative pressure. Normally there is always a negative pressure inside. So this is suction, irrigation, and this is hanging drop. Just few drop, this is hanging. And then lift the abdominal wall and it will go. It is sucked. This is confirmation. After that you will attach the tubing of the insufflator, and then you put the insufflator to the pediatric mode. And slow and careful oblique hold. You should not leave it unattended. And you see, only that much vares needle is in, maximum vares needle is out. And then slow and careful hold. After 100 to 200 ml of gas in, you will palpate and liver dullness should get obliterated. But your eye should go to the insufflator first. And here it is palpation. If you see the insufflator readings, it will immediately let you know where the gas is going. If you will see here, that this is the reading of the insufflator. What is the set pressure? 8. Mode is pediatric. Actual pressure is 0. Set flow is 0.7 liter per minute because it is a 7-year-old child. If this child would have been 1-year-old, then the flow will be 0.1 liter per minute. And actual flow is also 0.7. 100 ml of gas has gone. 0.1. Isn't it? So this is quadromanometric indicator which you should must see. And then slowly, slowly, slowly it is increasing and it will go. Once the 8 will established, flow will become 0. Sometimes 6-8, 5-8, 6-8, 5-8, it happens because of movement of diaphragm. So you should be wait till this 8 is stable. 8 is stable. And then you should enter into the abdomen with the trocar. So, knowledge of insufflator, it's a fantastic machine which has a lot of intelligence, and you should develop your capacity to talk with this machine, and it will help a lot of your complication will be solved. Insufflator problems, especially hypothermia, dryness of intestine, going in the wrong space, it will tell you. It is going slowly and you will wait. 400 ml of gas has, or 500 ml of gas is in, and maximum 700 ml, this patient will get 8-8. And this is pediatric mode. You may bring it to 12 also in pediatric patient. 8 is safe. And even in the pregnant woman also, you should use less gas. So now remove the vares needle, once the pressure, and then extend the incision. With keeping the sharper edge of the knife, you will extend towards you, little oblique, and sharper edge up. So don't cut the rectus. Always cut the skin only. And sharper edge up, and again sharper edge up, you're away. So this is how you should cut. And this is now U-shaped incision. This is a smiling incision. A smiling incision. After that, you take a mosquito forceps and dilate by opening and jaw, open and jaw, open and jaw, open and jaw. Couple of times, you will dilate it. dilate it. And then, now you hold the trocar carefully. Trocar should be held same way. This is the index finger should be pointed towards the sharp end. Only 6 cm of the trocar is empty. Middle finger is wrapping around the air inlet. This is middle finger. And thinner eminence is sitting over the head of the trocar. And then a screwing movement, you are in. Then remove the thinner and there is a hissing sound. Psss. Remove the trocar and then push the cannula further in. If cannula is going further in, that means you are in. If cannula is somewhere in pre-peritoneum, it will not go in. It will stop. Without trocar, it will stop. So you push and it is going further in. After that, attach the tubing off. Increase the flow rate to 6 liters per minute. In some of the insufflator, manually you don't have a privilege to set the flow rate on your desired level. They have 3 settings. Low flow, medium flow and high flow. Low flow means varicine. Medium flow means normal surgery. And high flow means emergency, yes. Emergency means bleeding. Bleeding or some other problem. Then you will be high flow. But remember, even if you are setting high flow, what does that mean? It will start flowing high. No. High flow means it is ready for high flow. No insufflator of the world you can tell the insufflator to go at this flow. Insufflator will decide its own. Only you can tell the insufflator this is your maximum flow. If it is not required, insufflator will not push the gas. Rather, it may take the gas back. But setting the high flow means emergency. Setting the medium flow means normally doing easy surgery. And setting the low flow means very simple. And in the advanced insufflator, you can set even 0.1 liter per minute flow rate. But in the normal insufflator, less than 1 liter per minute, you cannot flow. You cannot adjust. So now you will do that. And after that, you will put the other ports. So this is how the access is done in the pediatric patient. This is primary port, that is optical port. Now under vision, you will put other ports. So in most of the time, you have to deal with this. Now sometime, you need to go with the other port position. Like here, Palmer's point. In Palmer's point, generally Palmer's point is, according to book, the Palmer point is mid-clavicular line just below the costal margin. I will show you that suppose this is the patient, and here is the costal margin. It is 2 cm below here. But we do some modification. What modification is that we hold the this fold of the lower umbilicus and stretch it down. So actually this portion over the rib come here. Advantage of this is that after surgery, once you leave it, it will go up. And no hernia chances. You don't have to repair. So this is possible. This is what you are seeing here. This is the way to lift the abdominal wall and stretch it down. It is impossible. You know, pleura is more posteriorly, isn't it? Anteriorly, it is only up to the 8th or 9th intercostal. It never go down. And rather, we are above the rib. We are on the abdominal wall, isn't it? And you have to stretch it hypochondrium. So there will be no pleura. Absolutely no. Nobody has, I think, ever damage the pleura in Palmer's point. Posteriorly, it is more down, isn't it? This is our costal margin like that. So now just you give one small staple. After that, you take a varus needle and point the varus needle completely towards the stomach, here, as if you want to puncture the stomach. And if you will try to puncture the stomach, you will not puncture the stomach. And you will try to save the stomach, you will puncture the splenic flexor of colon. Suppose you go towards the anus, you will go splenic flexure of colon, or you will go towards the spleen, there is a danger. Here you will get three click sound. Anterior oblique aponeurosis, posterior oblique aponeurosis, and patent. So you go, one, this is two, and this is three. After that, here also you should do irrigation, suction, and hanging drop test. So hold it, attach it, irrigate it, suck it, and then take a hanging drop, put few drop of saline and suck it. And after that, start the insufflation. Palmar point is must-having point wherever umbilicus is diseased. Like in this patient, there was an incisional hernia. And you can see hernia sac is distending. And there was a lot of bubble adhered. If you would have put in the umbilicus, you will perforate the bubble. So this was the hernia which is popping up. So for all the ventral hernia, Palmar point always uses as an optical trocar. But even for gynecologist, if suppose hernia is there and you have to do the ovarian cystectomy or TLH, first you will introduce the port in the Palmar's point, and after that, under vision, you will put the trocar. This is the trocar going now in the Palmar's. And once the trocar is entered, after that put the gas, and then under vision you can put the ports there. Direction of the trocar should be towards the stomach. Now, sometime in obese patient, you have to do another strategy. In obese patient, various needles should go through the inferior crease of umbilicus. This is various needle. Inferior crease of umbilicus. You will give just one stab wound. And remember, as I told you earlier, there are three exceptions of oblique entry. One is morbid obese patient. In morbid obese patient, if you like to enter oblique, you will go in the somewhere in the fats. Yes, subcutaneous fat somewhere. Other exception is any lower midline laparotomy. If there is any scar below the umbilicus, you should not go oblique, you may damage the bubble. And third exception is diagnostic laparoscopy under local anesthesia. In that situation also, we should go perpendicular, because you cannot anesthetize the entire oblique pathway of the entry of the varus needle. And the patient will jump, she will cry. So this is varus needle is going, and assistant is lifting the abdominal wall. Because that much thick abdominal wall alone, you will not be able to lift it. So two hand this side, two hand that side, and then various needle perpendicular. After that, you attach the insufflation tubing, irrigation, suction, this is irrigation, then suction, then hanging drop test, and then insufflation tubing will be attached. Here, in the obese patient, you can keep the preset pressure up to 18 millimeter of mercury. So that heavy abdominal wall has to be lifted up. A lot of fat there in the subcutaneous skin. So that's why this is 18. And see, 18 is reached also. And it is 4.1 liter gas has used. And this 3 is not in the beginning. In the beginning it was 1. And after 1 liter it is 3. Is it clear? And this is the 18 is reached. That means now you are ready to put the trocar. Once you are ready to put the trocar, then you should go approximately, this is done, pneumoperitoneum is completed, and then approximately one hand width up this way, and then here, or you measure from this side. And then this is, you will give incision, that is transverse incision, along the Langer's line. Various needle was introduced through the umbilicus, and trocar is now supra-umbilical. And then you put a trocar and it should go perpendicular by just little support, index finger pointed, middle finger wrapped around the air inlet, head of the trocar over thenar eminence, and then slowly you will enter in by a screwing move. And after that, other ports. Now other ports, I will tell you how to put other ports, but later. Now, open technique. Why open technique? Blind is blind. In various needle technique, we are expecting is all is well below the umbilicus. But you may never be true. Might have patient has a tuberculosis of the Koch's abdomen when patient was 2 years old. She doesn't or he doesn't remember. Only mother knows. And treatment was done, it was cured, but it is adhered, bowel is adhered. Might have gastroenteritis or typhoid. And it was impending perforation, a lot of adhesion. Might have aortic aneurysm. You never know. The ultrasoundologist has only seen the ovary because patient has paid only for lower abdomen ultrasound. And he has ignored the aorta. And there was aortic aneurysm and your variation will directly go. Blind is blind. There is a definite, a small risk. Definite a small risk in the various renal technique. Because it's a blind technique. So Hassan has invented this trocar. This is called as Hassan trocar. It has one cone and one blunt trocar. Hassan trocar is available and you can use it in any cannula. This is the cone. This is the cone which can be attached, and this is a blunt trocar, it will not injure, completely blunt. And after that, you will do it. It was in 1974 when he has invented it. Now it is available in disposable as well as reusable. It has a metal or plastic sheath and blind tip trocar, means blunt tip trocar. Hassan technique, if you will compare, question is asked. Question is, Hassan technique is markedly superior than the various needle technique as far as the bowel injury is concerned. True or false? False. This markedly word has made it false. It is slightly superior than the various needle as far as the bowel injury is concerned. Do you know bowel injury has happened even in Hassan technique? If serosa is directly completely incarcerated, then even in the Hassan technique you can injure the bowel. Now second question. The Hassan technique is markedly superior than the various needle technique as far as great vessel injury is concerned. True or false? True. Can you injure the aorta in Hassan technique? Impossible. You have to do a lot of work to reach the aorta in Hassan technique. Isn't it? Have you perforated the aorta any time in laparotomy? I don't think so. So this is how the twist of the word can change the answer. These are the, I am disclosing the questions for your exam. So this type of question, you have to be careful reading the question twice. Because they are made in a way that you should do the wrong answer. You know that, but you will do wrong. So this is important. And Hassan port should be used. Now, there are two ways of Hassan technique. One is original Hassan, and second is modified Hassan. Nowadays, modified Hassan is more popular than original Hassan. Original Hassan was sutured, modified Hassan by Cocker. So, how to do, I will show you. You use two Elis forceps, and over the inferior crease of umbilicus, you will give a longitudinal incision. Stretch the skin and cut up to 1 centimeter below. After that, apply the Elis forceps either side. One Elis this side, one Elis that side. And then take a scissors or mosquito. Remember, palmer should never ever, sorry, Hassan should never ever be given on the base of the umbilicus. Otherwise, at that level, all the layers are fused together. It won't give you any benefit. After that, you take a scissors or mosquito and dilate the subcutaneous deep fascia and subcutaneous fat. Either way, this side and that side. Stretch the subcutaneous fascia, fat, and then you clean that area to get a shiny fascia and catch the rectus by Cocker and lift it up. Rectus, this is rectus sheath. And holding by Cocker. This is important. In the original Hassan, instead of rectus, a bite was taken with a suture to lift it. But in modified Hassan, you will use a cocker to lift the rectus. One this side and one other side, two cocker forceps is required. If you have cut the skin longitudinal, then now you have to cut the rectus transverse. You lift it like that. Purpose of this cocker is that it can lift the abdominal wall so that abdominal wall will go away from bubble. And purpose of suture also in original Hassan technique was same. Lift it up. By two hands, assistant will lift it as much as can. And cocker will keep the rectus. Remember, rectus should be pure rectus. It should not be fascia. Otherwise, it breaks. And then with the knife, you will cut in the middle. Because a skin was longitudinal, so rectus will cut transverse. And remember, only you are allowed to cut the rectus. Apart from rectus, you should never ever cut anything except. If you are cutting the peritoneum also with the knife, all the advantage of Hassan technique is lost. Because if there was any adhesion, it will puncture the bubble. So only cut the rectus. And once the rectus is cut, after that remove the knife and take a mosquito or scissors. And just like the bird which digs the tree, you puncture it bluntly. Blunt puncture with the hemostat, not with the knife. And then open the jaw. And here you are. Blunt in. And this is open technique. After that, you take two small S retractor. This is S retractor. And S retractor is in. After that, you take a bite on the full thickness rectus. One bite this side. This S retractor will make it safe because all the omentum or bubble will be pushed down. And then you can take one bite on one rectus, full thickness. This is a rectus. And one bite on other side. Advantage of this suture is a lot. This is one bite this side, one bite that side. And this is omentum. Now you take the cannula, Hassan cannula, and adjust it. Adjusting is very important. That you have this Hassan cannula and you will introduce it in, and according to thickness of abdominal wall you have to adjust. So you open it, enter inside, and this you can adjust it that level also. So this is adjustment is important. And tight it. There is a screw, you will tight it at this level. It is now fixed. Do you know why? Our conventional cannula, anytime you can pull it more, anytime you can pull it less. But here it will be stabilized by the suture. You got the point? So repeatedly if you will pull it in and out, you have a mess. And gas will leak so much, it will not be plugged. So you should decide it nicely, and according to thickness of abdominal wall, you should adjust it. And this is the blunt trocar. With the trocar, you will introduce it in. So this is important, and you will do this. And now, the two sutures will be used to stabilize the cannula and at the end to close the wound. This is the adjustment of the cannula. Cone will be adjusted. If the thickness is less, bring it at the tip. If obese patient, this cannula will be here. The cone will be shifted and then tightened by a screwing movement. You will tight it. Once it is tightened, after that you will enter there. So slowly now it is entering, and you remove the S retractor. And the same suture will be used to fix the cannula with the sleeve there. There is a hole in the sleeve. There is a split here in the sleeve, which is half cut. Do you know why they make this hole? So that you don't have to tie a knot. There is a half cut it. I will show you. This is important. That you don't have to tie a knot. You just need to put it into this groove. and automatically the suture will lock. If you not put in the groove, if you tie the knot at the end when you want to close the post, you will be short of the suture. Can you see that? Here is a split, isn't it? Here is a groove there. Why? To fix the suture. Just two times. You don't have to tie the knot. Why it is important? Because at the end, you should have a long length of the suture remaining so that you can close the wound. Isn't it? If you tie, and time to time you have to refix it. Because suppose it is a little out due to any reason. You may have to tight it again. And if you will tie a knot, you may not so easily tight it again. So this is a sleeve there. Here, this is a cut sleeve. And now, just this suture will fix into this groove. Either side. This side and that side, two, three times, fold it there. In this groove, that's all, it is done. After that excess of the suture, you may cut. And then, you will remove the trocar and introduce the telescope. Here it is fixed. And then you will introduce the telescope. This is important because conical shape, if you not stabilize by the suture, has a tendency to come out. Because it is conical. Why it is conical? Because it is a mini laparotomy. And the incision size vary, patient to patient. Some patients 10, some patients 11, some 12, some 13, some 14. Because of manual, it is not, you are not doing with the trocar, manual. So that's why it is conical. And at the end, the same suture which you have used will be used to close the port. So this is how Hessian technique is important and you have to do it. So at the end you can cross the upper one with the right, lower one with the left and tie a knot. This is called as tumble square knot, which we will learn subsequently in the other stage, and then it will slide. And you pull it and then tie the knot. So same suture will be used to close the port. So Hessian technique is very good, but it is time taking, you need patience, and you need to close the port very nicely, otherwise hernia can develop. It has little more hernia if care should not be taken to close it. Because it is always bigger than 11 mm. It cannot be completely tight. VG port is a very good instrument which is used by some of the company to make it optical trocar. There are different type of optical trocar I have shown you. This is VG port. VG port cost is a big factor. It is costing you approximately $500. And it has a pistol grip trocar in which you can introduce the telescope. And this is simple cannula, 5 to 12 cannula with the universal reducer. You put a various needle, then take the trocar and cannula and you will introduce it in. You have to introduce a 0-degree telescope, white balancing, focusing, and push it into the trocar. And then introduce it into the cannula, and then fire. With each firing, 1 millimeter blade comes out. This blade will cut the layers, each firing, you have to fire, you will feel like you are in police. And here it is, cutting the blade, this is sharp blade, which keep on cutting with each firing. And slowly, 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 slowly it enters inside that. This is the actual clinical footage. This is the subcutaneous fat. This is the fascia. This is peritoneum. This is peritoneum. And then you are in the abdomen. Suddenly it becomes black. That means you are in the abdomen. But remember, the complication has been reported with the VG port also. So don't think that buying this instrument will eliminate all the risk of access. No, it is your technique which is more important rather than buying the expensive instrument. Another good option is Turnamian trocar. This was invented by a German surgeon whose name was Turnemian. You have to introduce the telescope, and the tip of the trocar has an oblique knife-like cut. And then you keep on screwing into the abdominal wall. Just like the machine which bore the earth to take the water, it keep on a screwing movement, and it enters. Some surgeons, they use, this is the blade part of the trocar. So this is less used nowadays, but people still, some of them you might have seen, they use Turnemian trocar. Then comes a step trocar. This is also very good. A step trocar was basically used in the America by company who has launched it to prevent the malpractice of selling the used trocars. In America, if you will see what happens, that if one time they have used, they repack it and sell into the grey area in black market. And then it will be pushed into the developing country. Because even one time used trocar looks as good as new. Like if this trocar is used 10 times, 10, 15 times, but if I will pack it, you may not made it out that it is used or not used, if it is packed. So they open the pack carefully and then keep the pack carefully, and after use they put it and repack it and sell it. This is a big, so they made it now breakable trocar. After use it breaks, and it is impossible to reuse it. Another big advantage, it is radially dilating. So initially it is 3 millimeter, and then you will push 10 millimeter inside this 3 millimeter, and it will stretch. And after a stretch it will become like this. Is it clear? So this is called radially stretchable dilating trocar. That's why it is called a step trocar. It has many advantages. One of the advantages, chances of hernia is less. Because only a skin is cut, rest of the layer is stretched. Other advantage is that after one use, during use itself it destroys. You cannot reuse it. Just like an IV needle, IV cannula. Inside is metal, outside is plastic. And once you use in one patient, and even in 1% you prick one time, second time pricking is very difficult. You have to throw it and take new one, because it gets destroyed. So this is also very good, but in developing country, nothing is disposable. So you have the big problem, because every time 6,000, 7,000 is the cost, $100 for one trocar. Four trocar, $400 for port only. So that is the concern. So this was regarding the access technique. Now I am going to discuss secondary ports. Are you ready or are you tired? Ready? So secondary port. So where to put secondary port? We have to follow the baseball diamond concept. Primary port, is there any question? Yes? Fielding technique. Very good. Fielding technique is very good technique to perform the surgery where you have to put a saline. Wherever you are expecting intra-abdominal adhesion, a lot of adhesion, you will take saline and you will inject it around the umbilicus, and under ultrasound guided you will enter there. Ultrasound guided, because as you know, ultrasound is one of the best mode for what? For the fluid. And once you put the fluid, it will let you know. So if there is extensive intra-bowel adhesion, then that fluid will automatically give you the filling of the ultrasound. And then under the ultrasound V, with the fielding technique, you will enter inside. This is also a technique which many people they use. This is irrigation of the fluid around the area of the suspicion of adhesion and under ultrasound guided going. No, that is a Scandinavian technique. Umbilical tube is used in a Scandinavian technique, because fielding technique and a Scandinavian technique is written at the same place, so that's why you might have. But umbilical tube is Scandinavian and filling technique is by irrigation of the fluid. So this is also a very good technique which can be used during the access.
Could you repeat the primary port site for the
morbidity
of this patient?
Primary port site means?
Where should we put the primary port in a very obese patient?
You know, it depends upon which surgery you want to do. First tell me.
Bariatric surgery.
In bariatric surgery, various needle through the umbilicus, an optical port either 22.4 cm below the GPA sternum, or if you have a 36 cm instrument, suppose you don't have a bariatric instrument, then 18 cm from below the GPA sternum, and through the umbilicus approximately 5 to 10 cm above the umbilicus. But ideally don't make a umbilicus as a reference point. Because with the morbid, you know, if BMI is 45, then umbilicus go up to anterior superior iliac spine. And in super morbid obese, after 55, umbilicus go to scrotum. If you might have seen WWF sumo people, when they walk, their umbilicus is hiding their scrotum also. It is so down. So they use a cloth to hang it up and pull it up. So umbilicus should never be used in bariatric surgery as a reference point. If you have bariatric instrument available. Suppose you don't have bariatric instrument, you have a normal instrument and you want to perform bariatric surgery, then 18 cm. Because normal instrument has what length? 36 cm. Yes? No, not infra-umbilical. Yes, you can. You can. It is over the edge of the inferior crease. But remember one thing, that in inferior crease is not infra-umbilical. It is in the umbilicus. But in the inner margin, you are saying correct. If you go below, that's why we use Elie's forceps to evert the umbilicus to get the inner margin. Do you know, it is a very good question. If you are pointing towards the anus, then patient will be 15 degree head down. But if you are going perpendicular, like in obese patient or lower midline incision or any or Palmer's, if you are going perpendicular, then never ever put the patient head down. Because if you put head down, all the bowel and omentum come into the below the umbilicus. So at that time patient should be flat, so that the viscera will, all the omentum and bowel will be distributed evenly in all the quadrant of the abdomen. According to the way you are entering inside. First, for the primary port, not for the secondary. Yes?
Sir, how you should set the set flow for the open technique?
Do you know, open technique also the flow rate in the beginning after putting the trocar should be 1 liter per minute. Do you know why? If you will abruptly pull 10 liter per minute or 18 or 40 liter, patient will get vasovagal shock. Because abrupt increase in the abdominal wall will immediately collapse the patient. This is a rule even in the open surgery. If you have a big ovarian cyst, they are saying it, that collapse it, if you want to aspirate, carefully, slowly. Even the ascites when you are tapping, it should be collapse, it should be slowly. Because abrupt increase or decrease in the abdominal cavity, our body cannot tolerate. Yes?
Is it feasible to perform a deep pelvic surgery with a primary optical trocar as a Palmer's port?
Yes, but only it should be used as a safe access. Once you enter, then under vision you have to put one trocar in umbilicus. You don't want to bring it. No, I am telling you, the best way is to go with the Palmer's and under vision of the Palmer's put a trocar in the umbilicus and transfer telescope from here to there. This will be useless. It won't be of any use. Yes, yes. But suppose you have a small pelvic surgery, like Luna, that is of just lateral. Uterosacral ligament, you want to obliteration. And if you want to do these small Luna take maximum 2 minute time. You have to burn the uterosacral ligament attachment with the cervix, and you have to burn it. So if you want to do those surgery, you may continue with the palmars. Just like you might have seen that yesterday when we were operating, we were inspecting the abdominal cavity with the telescope in epigastric, isn't it? But if someone will do, tell it, perform this hysterectomy by keeping it in epigastric, it will be impossible. You will struggle. So if you have to do just diagnostic for pelvis or little bit endometriosis, then you may continue with the palmars. But if you have to do the advanced surgery in the pelvis, like hernia, like rectum surgery, or sacrocolpopexy, or sacrohistopexy, or even the TLH, then you cannot continue telescope keeping in the palmars. Under palmars, you have to put that again, transfer the telescope to the umbilicus. That is important. So now we will go to the baseball diamond concept of pole position. Laparoscopic instrument work on the lever action. Lever is important. Lever action, if you will see here, that abdominal wall is a fulcrum. The length of the instrument which go inside the abdomen is called as load arm, and length of the instrument which is outside the abdomen is called as force arm. And abdominal wall is a fulcrum. There are three types of lever: class 1, class 2, class 3. Class 1 lever, fulcrum is in the middle. Class 2 lever, it is near the load. And class 3 lever, it is near the force. So, if you want to perform the surgery better, you should always maintain a class 1 lever. Class 1 lever, the fulcrum is in the middle. This side is load, this side is force. Advantage of class 1 lever is that force and movement is equal and opposite. If you will move 5 centimeters outside, inside is 5. And if you give a 5 newton force this side also 5 newton force will be there. But if you will shift the fulcrum to one or other side, your complication starts. And after that, the force will be magnified, movement will be rectified. I am going to demonstrate you here how it happens. Let us see, suppose this is the instrument here. This is the instrument. And here is the, this hand is abdominal wall. Half instrument is in, half instrument is out. And when I am moving outside 2 cm, inside movement is also 2 cm. Outside 3 cm, inside movement is also 3 cm. But what happened? Suppose this is the appendix. Suppose this is appendix here. This is appendix. And suppose I am putting the port very near to the appendix, like this. Can you see that? Touching the appendix. Now what happened? Your instrument is type 2 lever. Now what happened if I am moving outside 10 centimeters? See, inside movement is only 2 centimeters. And outside, if you are gentle also, inside it will be a force is magnified. And this will be a big issue. Because as soon as your instrument become class 2 lever, your movement and force will be big problem. This is class 2 lever. Class 2 lever is used by the engineers to lift heavy object. Even if it is a very heavy box, this small child can lift this heavy box because he is intelligent, he is making class 2 lever. This arm is small, this arm is big. And force will be magnified. And movement will be less. Of course, he will move more this side movement will be less. So class 2 lever, it should not be there. So this is, if I am putting it like that, this is class 2 lever. Another problem, your elevation angle increases. And once your elevation angle is high, what happened? You have abduction. And third problem is direct coupling. Direct coupling means tip of the instrument is touching the uninsulated part of cannula. Can you see that? and it will create direct coupling. This cannula will get energized and bowel touching will burn. If half instrument is in and half instrument out, you will not get direct coupling. So these are the three problems which happens if you are nearer to the target. One is your instrument become type 2 lever, other is your elevation angle high, and third is direct coupling. Now, if you make type 3 lever, then also there is a problem. You will get overshooting and your elevation angle become narrow. How I will show? Suppose this is the target and my port is here, that much away. Now see, this is overshooting. Inside, overshooting. Outside, I will move 2 centimeters, and inside there will be a big swing. This overshooting can perforate the bowel, can perforate the diaphragm, and your elevation angle is too narrow, your handle of the instrument will touch the body of the patient. You cannot perform surgery. So, this is very important, that is, we should follow the first law of the baseball diamond concept. And what is that? Half instrument in and half instrument out. Our laparoscopic instrument should never ever become class 2 or class 3 lever. It remain class 1 lever, like a balance. Balance which is used by shopkeeper. If shopkeeper is keeping the fulcrum of the balance on one side or another side, will you like to buy the product from him? No, you will declare him as a cheater. So we should not be a cheater in laparoscopic surgery. We should be honest. An honest laparoscopic surgeon should put half instrument in, half instrument out. So how to do that? First you should try to find out the target. Now question is, what is the target? What is the target? Target is the most crucial part of dissection. For appendix, target is base of appendix. It is not the tip of the appendix. Suppose you have to do myomectomy, then target is the base of the myoma. For cholecystectomy, our target is cystic pedicle. For splenectomy, target is the hilum of the spleen. So first you try to find out the target, after that you try to find out the length of your instrument. Laparoscopic instruments are of which size? It is 36 or 28. These are the two sizes you have. I am not talking about here 1 centimeter. If you have 1 year old child, if you have 1 year child, you have 20. So as you know, you have 4 sizes of instrument available, 20, 28, 36 and 45. So let us talk right now about 36 or 28 centimeter. After that, you will draw the 2 arc, keeping in mind the target as a center. So this is target in the center, you will draw 2 arc, one is 18, other is 24. And accordingly, you will put your port. So let us assume that this is the target. Suppose you have to do a myomectomy and here is the target. This is. Now, one port will be here, one port will be here, one port will be here. If suppose you will put one port here and one port here, which type of lever it will form? Type 3. Yes. And if you will put just here, which type? Type 2. So this is the simple thing which you should know, that there are 3 laws. Telescope should be in the center, half instrument should be in, half instrument out, and manipulation angle should be 60 degrees. This is very simple. Half instrument in, half instrument out, telescope should be in the middle, and manipulation angle should be 60 degrees. So it looks like something like a field of a baseball. Telescope will be in the home position and 2 other instruments will be like that. If you will see here, it is, if India, baseball is not a very popular game, but in the overseas country, they play it a lot. This is like a baseball. This is the target. This is the one player. This is the second player, means one port, second port, and this is the telescope. Is it clear? This is telescope. This is telescope. This is the one. This is the another. And if you see here, it looks like a shape of a diamond also. Isn't it? So it looks like a shape of a diamond also. And it looks like a shape of a baseball. And what is the manipulation angle? 60 degrees. Very simple law. It doesn't matter who are you. You may be urologist, you may be surgeon, you may be gynecologist, you may be pediatric surgeon. You have to follow this rule. If you are not following, you are struggling. Because there is no substitute of ergonomics. Ergonomics is ergonomics. It has to follow. If you are not following, you are struggling. So, this is like a diamond shape and you will follow the port position. So, let us go for the different surgery. If you have to suppose perform the ovarian cystectomy, this is the left-sided ovarian cystectomy. Then you will put the port here and make an arc 18 and 24, keeping in mind this is 18 and then another 24. 18 is the half of the length of the instrument. 24 two-thirds. One instrument here, one telescope here, one instrument here and one instrument there. And where you will stand ideally to the opposite soldier. This is telescope, this is the right hand and this is the left hand. And ideally for left-sided hernia, left-sided varicocelectomy, left-sided ovarian cystectomy, all has same port position. And you should go near the opposite soldier. Gynecologist has one privilege. Privilege is that left-sided ovarian cyst, still they can perform standing to the left. Because by putting a uterine manipulator, they can drag the left ovary to the midline. But not always. Suppose you have a bad endometrioma, which is adhered to the iliac region, or with the sigmoid or tubo-ovarian mass, then left is impossible performing standing to the left. And suppose surgeon was the general surgeon and if you want to perform left-sided hernia standing in the left, he cannot bring the hernia to the midline. And if he will do like that, he will fall over the patient itself. Impossible. Nobody ever has performed left-sided hernia standing on the left. Have you seen anyone? Not possible. Left side hernia, you have to go to the right soldier. Otherwise, you cannot perform. And right side to the left soldier. So, this is how you will perform the ovarian cyst.
Is called entry
yes. Yes, this is very important that telescope should be anywhere in between 18 and 24. That's why we make two arcs. Otherwise, only one would have been sufficient, that is 18. Isn't it? Because why 18? 18 is the half of the length of instrument. But purpose of 24 is two. One purpose is for telescope, other purpose is bilateral surgery, where it will give you a common cutting area. I will discuss that ahead. Now, suppose you want to perform appendicectomy. So this is appendix, and here you will have Target is the base of the appendix, isn't it? And this is the arc. And it is very simple now. Suppose you have to decide where should be the port. It is very easy to consider. One port will be here. One port will be here. Isn't it? And one port will be here. That's fine. This is a telescope. I will put a telescope like that. I'll put one port here and one port there. And I will stand here and monitor will be placed at this point. So the question is, should I go to the OT by prakal, one compass, one scale and few color box sketch paint like your kid? Actually, if you go like that, it would be very nice. You will see that many of the surgeons, one very renowned surgeon, whose surgery also during colorectal surgery I will show you. He is from Strasbourg, France. And his name is Professor Wattage. You might have seen his video also on the YouTube. He before surgery is spending 15 minute time to draw the abdomen of the patient. He is doing drawing over that abdomen. And drawing on the abdomen and after that putting the port. So it is a good idea. Methylene blue and indigo carmine sketch paints are available. You can buy this. But if you don't want to use that, it is very easy. What you do, just you make a shape of a diamond by your hand and measure the distance of index finger from the 18 centimeter. Most of the time, if you will measure from index finger, this is called a snuff box, isn't it? This one. This is a snuff box. A snuff box is used by the laborers to put the snuff. Because their hand is dirty, so they use a snuff here. This is a snuff box. So most of the time in adult man hand, the distance of index finger to this snuff box is 18 centimeters. So this you will put it, and you will make a shape of a diamond by the hand. And thumb seed over the umbilicus, and index finger over the target. Question is, how I will see the target? Target is not visible. What to do? You go by the telescope is already in. Go by the telescope and touch the target and then touch the anterior abdominal wall. You will see the transillumination there, light. Or you can feel the tip also. So this is your target. Isn't it? Easily you can touch the anterior abdominal wall. And after that, put your index finger over the target and thumb on the umbilicus, like this. And one snuff box is your one port, another snuff box is your other port. And easily you can draw the line there. So this is one snuff box, is one port, this is thumb, this is another snuff box, and this is your index finger. And this way you can put the port easily. So let us continue for a small uterus. If you have a small uterus and if you are due to hysterectomy, then the port will be like this. You will put the 18 centimeter, and where should be the port? It is very easy. You will put one port here, and one port here. Isn't it? And you can perform that. In book, do you know what it is written? Most of the book, 3 centimeter medial and below the anterior superior iliac spine. And it is written correct, it is not written wrong, it is okay, it is correctly written. But it won't be the same if it is a large uterus. If suppose uterus is palpable, you should must go supra-umbilical. And suppose uterus is like that, then you cannot go in the umbilicus, you have to go here. This is supra-umbilical, and one port this snuff box, other port this snuff box. But tell me, with these three ports, it is good, you can take round ligament, fallopian tube, ovarian ligament. But these ports, can you take uterine artery? If you will take uterine artery, or if you will try to close the vault, which type of lever it will form? Type 3, yes. And you will be in trouble. So you need two additional ports. And one additional port will be here, and another additional port will be there. And that two additional ports, one port here, and one port here. This is important. So that, how many port you need? 5. So, 3 for upper pedicle and 3 for lower pedicle. And telescope can vary anywhere in between 24 and 18. Isn't it? Telescope is not an issue. Because telescope is not a part of lever. Because telescope is not doing the manipulation. Telescope is just a eye, your eye. And your eye can go nearer also and away also. And it is not in your hand. Your assistant is holding it. So don't worry about telescope. Telescope, time to time, you always need to tell your camera person, close up panoramic. Close up panoramic. Whenever you want to go nearer, you see, close up, close up, close up, he will go nearer. And it will get magnified. But whenever you want to see relative anatomy, you are taking. So 18 and 24, if it is less than 18, it won't work. Like if you have this umbilicus here, if you put in the umbilicus, your cannula itself will touch the fundus. Any palpable pelvic mass cannot be operated keeping the telescope in the umbilicus. You have to go supra-umbilical. Even ovarian cyst, even the fibroid, which is palpable, even the uterus, which you can feel, you have to go supra-umbilical, otherwise you will cry. During the surgery, your cannula will touch the pathology. Your telescope cannot go in and you will be big trouble. So any palpable mouth, you should must go supraumbilical. So that is why here it is going supra. So even the only surgeons, they don't need supraumbilical for upper abdominal surgery. Gynecologists also need supraumbilical for palpable pathology. So this is how the baseball diamond comes. So suppose there is a right-sided inguinal hernia. So this is the patient, here is the right-sided inguinal hernia. Then this is your target, is the deep ring. So you will make an arc like that. This is 18 centimeter, this is 24 centimeter. And telescope will be here, one port 7.5 centimeter lateral here, other port 7.5 centimeter lateral here. Telescope in the middle, this is telescope, and one port this side, and other port other side. This is right hand and this is left hand. And you must have to go to the opposite shoulder to perform surgery. And then you will perform this way. Suppose this is the port position and you will perform this hernia surgery, then it will be wrong. Do you know why? This instrument will make type 2 lever. This instrument will take 3 lever. And your manipulation angle will be how much? Less than 30 degree. You got the point? So same port position if you will use for other side of hernia, you will cry like anything. But for this size hernia, it is good. So, again, other example, suppose you have to do fundoplication. Here is the patient. And in fundoplication, our target is the gastroesophageal junction. This is the target, gastroesophageal junction. Now, keeping in this mind, in the center, you will draw the arc. This is 18. And that's why in the upper abdominal surgery, you have to go supraumbilical. You cannot perform the surgery working in the umbilicus. This is supraumbilical, 24. This is the telescope, ideally. And here will be the one port, and here will be the other port. Now the question is, where should be the fourth port or fifth port? Like in cholecystectomy, where should be the fourth or fifth? In those situations, fourth or fifth port should be minimum 5 centimeter and maximum 10 centimeter away from the nearest port. So suppose I have to use a stomach retractor or liver retractor, it should be away from my this port. Like suppose this is the port, then I can put one in the anterior axillary line, here one port. And if you want one more, you can put here. And then you can put all the ports. Remember, laparoscopic baseball diamond concept doesn't depend upon the size of the patient. It depends upon the size of the instrument. And you should remember the principle of four triangle. I will show you. This is triangle number one. This is triangle number second. This is triangle number third. This is triangle number fourth. This is umbilicus. This is a 1 year old child. This is a 5-year-old child. This is a 18-year-old man. And this is BMI 45 bariatric patient. In 1 year-old child, what will be your size of your instrument? 20. In 20 centimeter instrument, your port should go 3 centimeter either side. 3 centimeter this, 3 centimeter this. In 5-year-old, 28 centimeter instrument. So your instrument should go 5 centimeter either side. 5 centimeter this, 5 centimeter that. In adult, you should go 7.5 centimeter either side. This is 7.5, this is 7.5. And in the bariatric, you should go 10 centimeter either side. But still all the manipulation angle is same. Can you see that? all the benches. If you will make a triangle by a mat, match stick, it will be too near. Same triangle by a straw to take cold drink, it is away. Same triangle by a billiard stick, it will be far away. And same triangle by a bamboo, it will be many feet away. So what is the message here? That your port position always remains same if your instrument is same. 18 centimeter away, telescope in the middle, and either side 7.5, 7.5. Let us take other example. This is a small child. This child age is only 2 years. And here is the cecum. This is appendix. Appendix is inflamed. And this patient comes to you for appendicectomy. 1 year old child. Only 1 year. There is no pediatric surgeon in this community. You have to do that. And if you are doing this surgery by laparoscopy, you don't have pediatric instrument 20 centimeters. Where should be the port? Tell me where. One port palmar, one port epigastric, and one port lumbar. Got it? And you can perform surgery. If you don't do that, you put one port in umbilicus, one port here, one port suprapubic, you can do the surgery, but only with the cannulas. Even you cannot remove the cannula instrument out of the cannula also. Your cannula will touch the cecum, isn't it? Cannula will touch the cecum or not? It will touch. You can even not take out of the instrument out of the cannula, it will remain inside. Impossible. So, one port here, this will be telescope, this will be the one instrument, half in, half out, and this is another instrument. And then you will be able to perform. So, what is the message? Message is that it doesn't matter which size of the patient you have. If you are using 36 centimeter instrument, you have to go 18 centimeter from the target. Am I clear? If you are using 45 centimeter instrument, you have to go 22, otherwise you will sacrifice. What you will sacrifice? You will, your elevation angle will be high, you will get direct coupling, and your instrument will make type 2 lever. This is one. Other one more variation, one more thing you have to always remember during port position. Let us assume that you are performing a duodenal perforation. This is the patient, this is the oesophagus, this is the stomach, and here is the duodenal perforation. This is the duodenal perforation. Now, ideally, you will make an arc like that. This is my arc. And always target in the center. Here will be my one port. Here will be my one port. Here will be my one port. This is good. 7.5, 7.5 centimeter either side. And you go here. You go here. And you go here. This is good. And ideally, you should stand in between the leg. Here. In between the leg, ideally. Ideally, you should stand. Then only you will get 60 degrees. Is it clear? Suppose you don't want to stand in between the leg due to any reason. Any reason. Reason may be any. Maybe your table cannot split that much. Maybe your height is less. Less height surgeon has difficulty standing in between the leg because they need to bend. And especially if you are obese, then your abdomen will not allow you to bend. You will feel discomfort. So you want to stand here. Now if you want to stand here, your hand should be of a hand of a ghost to reach there. It has to be elongated. You cannot reach there. And if you try to reach there, you will drop over the person. It will be big and you will get a big backache, not perform. So how to do? There is a liberty to you. What you do? Bring this port here and bring this port here. And after that, you will be one port here and one port here. Can you see now your hand is, stretched hand is becoming less stretched, isn't it? You are reaching near. And telescope will be there only, telescope will not change. And you will see here, this angle will become 15 and this is 45. And still manipulation angle is 60. So this is called as azimuth angle. This is called as azimuth angle. And azimuth angle can vary from 15 to 45. Wherever you feel difficulty, you may decrease one side and compensate by the other side. And then also your work will be done. This is what we do in college spectrum. Let us see. College cystectomy, this is what we do. Here is the, this is the costal margin, here the rib cage, this is the gallbladder going, here is the cystic pedicle. Do you know what the French people they do? French people, they put one port in umbilicus, one port here and one port there, and they stand in between the leg. If they will put the port in epigastric, again they need to be, become a ghost to catch it there. They cannot reach epigastric. So they have better manipulation angle either side. But as an American, they stand here. Isn't it? So that's why we put one port here. So that if you see this port go like that, this port go like this, isn't it? And this is what? This azimuth angle is 15, this is 45. And this is also following the baseball diamond with compromising the azimuth angle of one side with the another. So every surgery and every surgeon of the world, they follow the baseball. But if they will ask you that why you are putting the port there, they will say it's good, very good, it is to put here. You see, why here? Then you see, it's good here, it's fine. So if you will follow the principle, then you will not do mistake and your every port will be the correct place. Now, let us take nephrectomy. In nephrectomy, your patient is kidney bridge position, transperitoneal, and it is retroperitoneal structure, much deeper. So that's why the kidney is made little above the body, because depth we cannot draw here. Depth we cannot draw in the two-dimensional picture, so that's why kidney was made above the body, because distance is more. And then you have 18 and 24. In nephrectomy, always, or splenectomy, always port is lateral to the umbilicus in midclavicular line, on the side of the kidney. So this will be the optical port in midclavicular line, on the side of the kidney. And one port here, one port here. And then telescope will be in the center. This will be your left hand, this will be your right hand, and you will perform the surgery. So this way, you will be standing in front of the patient, not behind. We stand behind the patient in open surgery or in retroperitoneoscopy. But in laparoscopic nephrectomy, you have to stand in front of the patient and you will follow the baseball diamond concept. So, let us take again example, if umbilicus itself is diseased, then what to do? Here also same principle. So your target is this now. Umbilicus itself is target. So, you draw two arcs, yes. And automatically you will see palmar will come in the arc. And telescope will be in the palmar's point. And under the vision of this palmar's point, you will take two other ports, 7.5 and 7.5. And after that, transfer the telescope to the midline. That is the telescope. And then use palmar's as your right hand instrument and the third one as your left hand instrument. And then you can perform the umbilical hernia surgery. So this way, any surgery, any specialist can perform and anywhere, not only in the abdomen, even in thorax, even in axilla. Yes? That means you want, if you have a two surgery.
Splenectomy plus cholecystectomy.
Together. Yes. So very good. I will discuss that. This is little bit in the next slide, few slide it is there. So your question is how to follow the baseball diamond concept if you have combination of surgeries. So we will discuss. Now, before going there, we should consider few things. Why telescope should be in the center? Why not to keep telescope away from you? Because if the telescope is in the center, you have better depth perception. Remember, in laparoscopy, we don't have a 3D view. But we see the depth. We know that what is deeper, what is nearer. Why? Because of depth Q. And there are many depth Q, like occlusion and relative size. Occlusion means if this table is occluding my body, who is nearer to you, me or this table? Table. If I am occluding this wall, who is nearer? Me. This is what? This is depth. Everybody know. Even if you have one eye, you will know that. You don't need binocular vision. Relative size. All of you standing in front of me, your face look big to me. And the person who is behind, their face is just small. Then, aerial gradient. Person who is far away, his face is hazy. Your face is more clear to me. Fogging. With the fogging, depth become blurred. Linear parallax. With increasing depth, two parallel lines meet each other. Motion parallax. If people who is far away, if they move more also, they'll move moving less. But nearer, it moves more. Then, texture gradient. Darker the texture. My tip of the nose is dark. That means nearer. Here it is. This is, sorry, shiny. That means nearer, bright, nearer. And dark means deeper. These all are the depth cue which our brain has developed. But these all depth cue is good if telescope is in the center. Do you know, we are very lucky that God has given both the eye in front. Fish is not lucky. Fish is unlucky. Because one eye is this side, another eye is that side. So from this side, fish is seeing different world. And from this side, fish is seeing different world. So they don't have depth perception. They keep on hitting the aquarium whole life. They don't know where it is. Because they don't have binocular vision. We have binocular vision. That's why we can do laparoscopy. Fish cannot do laparoscopy. Because they don't have binocular vision. But they are lucky in one sense that their field of vision is 360. If any big fish is coming from behind, they can see, they can run away. But we are unlucky in that way, that all our enemies, they talk behind us. And they smile once you go away. But behind you, not in front. So, horse is half lucky, half unlucky. In horse, their eye is, one eye is at this corner, another eye at that corner. So from half of the eye, they see same world. And from half of the eye, they see different world. That's why horse rider in the town, they cover half of the eye of the horse. Then horse get better depth perception. Immediately stop if something is coming in front. Because they are seeing only front, they don't see on the side. So they have better depth perception. But the same horse, when it is used in battlefield or race course, you never have seen covered eye. Because they want it to keep on running and depth perception is not required at that place. So exactly same way, if you keep the telescope in the center, you have better depth perception. And that's why most of the time we should use telescope in the center. Now his question that what to do if you have a two target. If you have a two target, you should draw the arc for both And then wherever common cutting area is, your port is there. Very easy. Suppose you have to do a splenectomy or ovarian cystectomy together. Or hemicolectomy. In hemicolectomy you have two remote targets. In those situations, this is because pediatric patient size of instrument is 20-20. And in 20 centimeter instrument, what should be the size of arc? 10 and 14. So this is the, when you operate here, one port will be like this, one port will be like that, telescope in the center, you will stand here and monitor should be there. And when this side of the surgery is over, this side of surgery is over, then surgeon will change his position. And surgeon will go where the monitor was, and monitor will be brought near the, so monitor will be here, this is monitor, surgeon is here, and with the same port, telescope is here, and one port in this direction, and one port in that direction, you can perform the other surgery also. This is a bigger surgery. Let us draw the simple surgeries. Like suppose you want to do bilateral hernia. In bilateral hernia, here is the, this is the patient, or bilateral salpingophrectomy, or you are doing radical hysterectomy and bilateral lymphadenectomy. So you have to work on both the iliac lymph nodes. Or you are a urologist, bilateral varicocelectomy. It is same for everyone. So this is one hernia or one testis for orchidopexy, or one varicocele, or one lymph node for gynecologist. Now, this is 18, this is 24. This is 18, this is 24. This is a common area. Can you see that? Which is crossed by both. So one port will be here, one port will be here, one port will be here. And you will stand where? Here. When you have to perform this surgery. Isn't it? And when you have to perform this side, you will go there. So if you, and then with the same port, you can perform other side also. Do you know, your angle will not be 60. Your angle will be 45. But this is the only best possibility you have. You don't have any other possibility. Best possibility is this only. Let us show you the real surgery. How in the bilateral hernia surgery works. In bilateral hernia surgery, this is the port position and how we do it. So, this is the port position for bilateral hernia surgery. Here, if you will see, if you have to do this side, port is like that. You have to do that side, port is like this. You have to do bilateral, all in the same line. Right will go a little up, left will go a little line. So, you will do either side with little compromise. Suppose, this is the port. Can you do this side hernia surgery with this port? Not possible. And can you do the right side with this port? Not possible. There will be swording. All the port will come same line. So what the baseball is saying, it is becoming judge. It is saying, okay, both will compromise. One go little up, other go little down. And it is solved. So you have to get a common cutting area. And then you can perform the port position with that area. So baseball diamond concept is applicable everywhere. Wherever you are performing surgery, and you can do. Like, let us show that here, this is a bilateral hernia surgery. This is the bilateral hernia, this is the patient, and suppose this is one side, or bilateral ovarian cystectomy, which surgery, it doesn't matter. Target matters. Which specialization, doesn't matter. Target is matter. So this is one, and again this is another 24. And this is a common cutting area, which you can see shared by both the sides. The telescope in the center, one port at this corner, other port at this corner. And then you can enter inside, you can perform. So this is a real photograph of real wound of a patient who has undergone bilateral hernia surgery. All the three ports. Otherwise, if you want correct 60 degree, how many ports you need? Five. Isn't it? Three for this side, three for this side, telescope will be common. Am I clear? So if you want correct 60 degree for bilateral surgery, you need five ports. If you want to compromise it with the three ports, you can do. Now disadvantage. There is a big disadvantage of this is, you know, whatever we have discussed so far is called as contralateral port position. Contralateral means one port this side, another port that side, and telescope in between. One of the big disadvantages is that hand of the surgeon is either side and hand of the camera is in between your arm and body here. If both are same sex, it is okay. If she is female, she will not allow you to hug it like this. This is a big headache. That freedom of the surgeon's movement is affected. You are stuck. And sometime camera person also, if it is tall, he will also have to bend. There is one way that you can put one other port. Another side, but you need two monitors. So, gynecologists, they hate this port position, contralateral port position. They invented ipsilateral port position. In ipsilateral port position, freedom of movement is there. So, what to do? Same appendectomy, same thing. In appendectomy, one port was umbilicus, one port right hypochondrium, one port suprapubic. What you do? You transfer the telescope to opposite side completely. That is called as sectorization. Telescope will go to the another sector, you will be in another sector. And then you can perform the surgery. This is very good. Especially if you are doing hysterectomy or other advanced surgery, you can put one port here. You can put one port here and you can put two ports there. This is called an ipsilateral port position. Ipsilateral port position is good because your arm will be by the side, but your manipulation angle will be 30 degrees. Ipsilateral port position is especially good where the organ is mobile. Like uterus. In uterus, by putting a uterine manipulator, you can go anterolateral, contralateral tracts. So let us assume a hysterectomy surgery. This is the patient. Here is the patient. This is the uterus. Here is the fallopian tube. This is the ovary. You put one port here, one port here, one port here. This is also same arc, but 7.5 either side. Do you know here also if we'll put telescope in the middle and these two, it will become contralateral. The angle is same, everything is same, only it is one side. Ipsilateral means one side only. So this is telescope. This will be the telescope like this. This is telescope. After that, you will put one port here. This is one instrument and this is other instrument. And what is your angle? You can see it is 30. It won't be, it will never be 60. And when you have to do upper pedicle, you operate, then this side also operate, you can operate. Do you know why you can operate? Because your uterus will create and it will give the soldier itself. Uterus is a very good cooperative organ. So when you are cutting this, and next time uterus will give you cut this. When you cut, uterus will give you cut this. Uterus will give you cut this. Any organ is not like that. that it give surrender to cut. Uterus only surrender to cut. If you tell the hernia to come to the midline, it will say, I don't have time to come there. You come, I will not. But uterus, contralateral, you can cut. But only fundus part of the uterus can support. When you go to the uterine artery, it won't. Uterus is not going to support you. And if you will go with the same port to take the uterine artery of other side, you are in trouble. No, it is difficult also and it will take you lateral. If you take the uterine artery of the same side, it is okay. Can you see that? Here it is fine. Do you know why? Because we are pointing towards the cervix. We are pointing towards the cervix here. It is fine. But if you go to the opposite side, it is not fine. It is taking you towards the ureter. Because if contralateral traction happens, where is the maximum movement? Upper pedicle. Is there any movement in the cervix? No, because that is axis. On the axis, movement is very less. You are in trouble. So what you do, you put one more port here. Contralateral. When you have to do this side of colpotomy, or when you do this side of uterine, you will go from here. Is it okay? So this is a mixture of ipsilateral and contralateral. So this is very good port position, which I will show you in reality how it is done. And in the real video, we will acknowledge it. So let us assume any surgery, like suppose you want to perform a surgery here, and this is a hysterectomy surgery going on. This patient has very bad uterus with the multiple fibroid. You can see this is subserous fibroid. Another is one below, posterior fibroid. One was cervical also. And this is the fibroid here. And this patient needs hysterectomy. So now you want to do the surgery. I will show you live videos also we have planned for. And I will demonstrate you in the OT. Now here is the, this is the ligature and this is the bipolar Maryland. Now tell me, anybody, what is the manipulation angle right now? 30 degree. Absolutely correct. This is 30 degree. And you can, if you will extrapolate the line, you can imagine it is both is coming from left side, isn't it? None is coming from right side. So it is which port? Ipsilateral. And telescope, if you will extrapolate, you will imagine that line in the brain, you will know it is coming from supraumbilical. Even not through the umbilicus, because it was a large uterus with multiple fibroid. And this is ipsilateral port. It is going on correctly. You keep on coagulating, cutting. This is upper pedicle on the right side. But it is doing fine, even on the right side. And you keep on continuing. Now let us go ahead. Now this is left side. Let me show you left side a little more. This is the left side. Can you see that? Left side is also going on. After that, this is the left side uterine artery. Here. Can you see the uterine artery? This is uterine artery. And this is left side uterine artery. This is uterus. This is bladder. And this is the left side uterine artery. Did you see that? And ligature in which side? Same side? Same side. So the tip is pointing where? Towards the bladder, towards the cervix. So ureter is not damaged. But tell me, from this side, is it good to take the uterine of other? Not good. And if you try to do, you will be in trouble. So this side of uterine is okay. This is uterus, this is uterine of left side. It is cooked by the ligature, keeping in the left. But when you do to the right, you should make one more port for the right here. Did you see that? And this is the uterine of the right side. And tell me, holding like that, is it possible from opposite side? It won't be possible. So many situations, you have to mix the port position of ipsilateral and contralateral. Easy part, you can do by ipsilateral, and the difficult part, you can do contralateral. But in advanced surgery, you don't have a scope of ipsilateral. A nephrectomy cannot be performed ipsilateral. A fundoplication, hiatus hernia cannot be ipsilateral. A splenectomy cannot be ipsilateral. Appendicectomy can be ipsilateral. Why? Mobile organ, easy surgery. Ovarian cystectomy, ipsilateral. Hysterectomy, ipsilateral. Radical hysterectomy, no ipsilateral. Lymphadenectomy, no ipsilateral. So, this is important to keep in mind that sometimes gynecologists or even the surgeons, they do ipsilateral surgery. In ipsilateral, there is nothing except change in azimuth angle. One azimuth angle is 30, other azimuth angle is 60. Isn't it? And manipulation angle is how much? 30. Manipulation angle is not 60. So this is, you can perform. Now, another good thing what to do is tap block. Tap block means transversus abdominis block. Do you know, in between the costal margin, this is rib, iliac crest, and this is costal margin. In between iliac crest and costal margin, there are nerves of the abdominal wall going. Those nerves are called as transversus abdominis block nerves, and those can be blocked. So, if you will see this ultrasound, in this ultrasound, you have a skin, then this is external oblique muscle, this is internal oblique muscle, this is transversus abdominis muscle, this is peritoneum. So what you can do, you can, under ultrasound guided, you can prick the needle and you can go to the transversus abdominis muscle plane. Here needle is coming. And you can inject the 10 ml xylocaine, lignocaine or bupivacaine in this area. Tap block is very good for the patient who want day care surgery. So that up to 24 to 48 hours, there is no, absolutely no pain post-operatively. So here it is pricking it here, and then you will, under ultrasound guided, remember, if it will go in the abdominal cavity, no advantage. And it is in external oblique also, no advantage. Because all the pain nerve fibers travels the transversus abdominis muscle plane. So that's why it is called as tap block. That means transversus abdominis plane block, ultrasound guided. If you want to open a day care surgery, like suppose you want to open a surgical center in Dubai, here it is written in transversus abdominis. And if you want to open a full-fledged hospital, a lot of formalities are there, a lot of formalities, this guidance, this license, pollution, this, that. But if you will make a day care surgery, then it is just like a clinic. Many of the 50% of the official work will be reduced. But day care means at night patients should not be present in your hospital. And they are very funny. They come at night also to see. They come at any time to see. Because it's a small city. In India, nobody cares. But because that much big population is difficult to control. So they come to inspect you only once they have to take money. Otherwise, they are sleeping. But they repeatedly come. So at night, you cannot keep the patient. You have to discharge by evening. And at night, patient will call, I am dying due to pain. So tap block is essential in day care. So here it is a needle going, and you will inject the transversus abdominis plane xylocaine there. So this is a good technique, which your anesthetist of course will do, but you should insist that I want tap block. He should have training, otherwise he should get a small training available in many places, and it is good for laparoscopy. So ultrasound guided, here it is. It is now, this is the fluid, black color, you can see, and patient is very good, a smooth surgery. Other alternatively, you can inject it over the wound also, but it is better to inject before giving incision, not at the end, so that inflammatory reaction will not be triggered. Other way to inject some saline over the diaphragm in cholecystectomy to prevent the irritation. So these are precautions. Now let us discuss about the complication. One of the complication is a small bowel injury. That is 50% of all the injury is a small bowel injury. Here you can see, if you go inside and you see any yellow thing coming out, you should be immediately careful, and most of the time, here is the perforation. If this happened, what to do? Put a gauze piece, immediately wipe it out. Don't use lavage. It will transmit to the other area. Again, with the betadine, with the gauze piece, clean it and suture it. Primary closure. You don't need any laparotomy. Even if you do laparotomy, you will do same, and it may create more problem. Another is vessel injury. These type of vessel injuries are very common, where accidentally you will puncture and you can injure it. These are the iliac vessel, mesenteric vessel, aorta. But do you know, I am not happy with this Chandler's study which was published in 2001, because it is too much. 32% iliac vessel of all the injury, and vena cava 8.4%. It is old data. It is 18 year old. Now the surgeons are smart. They don't perforate that much. But still it is available. Yes, but do you know this is in 309 injury? Yes. Patient will run away. No. One thing please, take see here. It is 31% of 309. It is not, yes. And totally it is, if it is 1.1%. So it is 10,000 study. In that 10,000, 309 vascular injury. And among 309, 8% is. So this study is not like that in 100% 32. In 309, 32 means this is there. And this study is old study. So I will not tell you to believe it, because it is fearful. So other incidence is trocar site injury. Here we can see some blood is reaching to the liver, and here is the trocar site. Most of the time, why trocar site injury happened? Because with the knife, surgeon wants to stab the abdominal wall, especially secondary trocars. You should not do. They like to see the tip of the knife by telescope. They don't do that. You should only cut the skin. And another reason is bladed trocar. Bladed trocar means disposable trocars. So you go with the hook, coagulate it, or go with the bipolar, coagulate it, or you use suture passer to close the port, due to pressure it will stop. Or you use a Foley's catheter, put a Foley's catheter, inflate it, and tamponade effect. Sometime inferior epigastric injury. This is also a big injury which happens, especially with the bladed trocar. Here we can see this is a blade of the trocar entering, this is blade. And blade is cutting, and its blade has cut. And then massive inferior epigastric vessel injury starts. And then you need to go and coagulate it. First remove the trocar, put the finger, and with the finger you will give the pressure. If that doesn't work, then go with the bipolar coagulate. If that also doesn't work, then with the suture passer, you have to do port closure, because huge hematoma will keep on forming. And that may be abscess and other problem. Death is rare, but it may be possible. So this is suture passer. Go with the suture facial closure needle or varus needle, both you can use. Drop the suture there, go to the opposite side, again catch it and pull it out. And this way, inferior epigastric injury can be controlled. Inferior epigastric vessel injury is very common in gynae practices also, because most of the trocars are around the inferior epigastric vessel injury. So always put the telescope, turn the light cable down, have a view there of inferior, and then you go there. How to safe entry, I will discuss during gynae procedure. And when I will discuss pelvic anatomy, then I will demonstrate you how to rule out. So this is also one of the injury. You tie the knot, it will be okay. Gas embolism means various needle has gone into the vein, and gas embolism, 1 into 10,000 to 1 into 60,000 is reported. In 10,000, 1% they died due to gas embolism. It is lethal. It is always mortality may happen. Other complication is pneumo-omentum. You will go inside and you will see like a crystal ball like omentum. If it is not disturbing you, you don't disturb. You do surgery, come out, it will be absorbed its own because it is CO2. Another is surgical emphysema, which he has pointed out that sometimes we create a lot of insufflation in subcutaneous plane, and in elderly it happens frequently. Pneumomediastinum is also one of the complications because sometimes there is a small opening in the mediastinum like this, and with gas enters into the mediastinum, and that give you the collapse of the lung. Lung will get collapse. So this type of pneumomediastinum is a rare complication which need immediately conversion to the open surgery. Normally we open mediastinum even in fundoplication or hiatus hernia, but it is a big opening. So gas enter, come out, enter, come out. But this is a small congenital defect which act as a valve. So with each movement of diaphragm, gas go to the mediastinum but doesn't return back, like a tensor pneumothorax. How you will know your patient? Airway resistance increases, your anesthetist will say, I cannot inflate the lung, I don't know why. You will bring a C arm, take X-ray, you will see a black tubular shadow in the middle. Pneumomediastinum is a very common complication, and you can encounter any time. If you will type the pneumomediastinum and laparoscopy, you have many, sorry, I got confused, but it will be correct. Google is smart. This is all pneumomediastinum, and these are the images of pneumomediastinum. Here it is, all the black shadow in the center. So these patients immediately conversion to the surgery. This is all pneumomediastinum. This is the black shadow. So it should be immediately stopped and surgery, and then continue. This is also a rare complication which can you should keep in mind. So distance between instruments should never be less than 5 cm. Any instrument, lateral instrument, optic or two instrument. Otherwise, it will start swording at the level of abdominal wall itself. You will not be able to continue the surgery. Mirror image is blunder. If the either side azimuth angle is 30-30 degree, then what port position it will be called? Either side 30-30 degree, contralateral port position. If one side 30 and again same side 60, then ipsilateral. And if it is more than 90, then it is called as mirror image. Mirror image is blunder. It is a big mistake. Never ever try to bring more than 90 degree azimuth angle. Otherwise, vision axis and action axis will be opposite to each other. That is called mirror image, and you will not be able to move the instrument. If you move the instrument right, it will go to left. Paradoxical movement will be there. So this is also kept in mind. Now this is a summary. So I will not torture you. This is your last slide. And this is after that you are free. So this is summary. Summary is, laparoscopic instrument should always make like a type 1 lever. Telescope should be in the middle of the working instrument. Manipulation angle should be 60 degrees. Elevation angle should be 30 degrees. Distance between two working instruments should not be less than 5 cm. Distance between two working instruments should not be more than 15 cm. Working instrument. Two working instruments, not telescope and instrument. What should be telescope and instrument? 7.5. Azimuth angle should be minimum 15, maximum 45. Ideally 30-30 degree either side. Is it correct? And shadow of the telescope should be below, so light cable should be kept up. So if you will just follow the this principle of baseball diamond concept, then you will never suffer from the wrong port position and your ergonomics will be perfect. Either you choose ipsilateral or contralateral, you can perform this. So, any question? Yes?
As you know, hernia in pediatric age group can be occur at when first week.
Yes?
At what age you can access laparoscopy?
Do you know, as you know, that it should be at 18 months. After 1 year, it can be repaired by laparoscopy. And as you know, in pediatric hernia, you don't have to do anything, just you have to make a purse string.
Yes.
Around the peritoneum.
So,
the port position? Port position is same, I will show you. Port position in pediatric hernia, I will show you where to put. So, this is the I have to take one lecture for you, the pediatric consideration in minimal access surgery. Here is the port position. This is the port position for pediatric hernia. You have to put one port in umbilicus, one 3 cm this side, 3 cm that side. Again, same way baseball. A needle should be percutaneously passed. Can you see that? Here. It should be perfectly passed. This is the port position. Contralateral. Do you know in pediatric you don't have that much space to create ipsilateral. In pediatric ipsilateral is impossible. This is the contralateral port position. 7.5, 7.5 is not possible. So 3 or 5, depending upon your size of instrument. And then you will perform the surgery. And this is 60-degree angle. Telescope in the center and you will do like that. And how you will operate? You will just give an incision and you will operate like that. This is the purse string suture you have to apply on all around the peritoneum and tie a knot. And if you can see very carefully, you have a contralateral port position. Can you see? One instrument is coming from this side, other instrument is coming from that side. And your manipulation angle is 60 degrees. The one side is the left hernia, other side is hernia, right hernia. So in pediatric also the same principle is followed. But arc will be small if your instrument is small. Isn't it? So any other question? This in detail I will discuss later when I will discuss hernia surgery. Yes, 24 centimeter has two purposes. One purpose, it is the maximum limit of the telescope where it can go. And other purpose is if you have a bilateral surgery, it gives you a common cutting area in which you can put your both the ports. Because 18 is the half of the length of the instrument and 24 is two-thirds of the length of the instrument. Two-thirds of the length of the instrument. So, more than two-thirds you cannot go out because it will start, handle itself will start touching. Isn't it? Suppose you will put your port 40 centimeter away from target, you may not be able to reach there also. Forget about type 2 or type 3 lever. You will not be able to reach also. Isn't it? So, that's why maximum two-thirds in you can keep, but better half. So that's why, and if you have only one-sided hernia surgery, you don't need 24. That's why when we make the diamond shape with our hand, we have only 18, we don't have a 24. So your job is that today once you go hostel, take a scale from index finger, measure where you reach 18. And remember that point. And if you forget, you make a tattoo there. But I don't think your hand, you can, yourself, you cannot forget. So in the female, it doesn't go a snuff box. Sometimes it comes to a stellate process. So you have to measure your hand and remember where is your teen. And then put the thumb on the umbilicus, index finger over the target, and you have your port. So you want to ask something? Yes? Mirror image will be clear once we will put a prize for you. I am going to demonstrate baseball diamond concept tomorrow in the lab, around 10:30. So what we will do, we will put a piece of paper written 1, 2, 3, 4 inside the abdomen. And one side we will put telescope, other side your image, your instrument. And you have to touch written ABCD there. And anybody, if you will be able to touch, you will get $100 prize. You will not be able to touch even written ABCD. Why? Because if you want to move left, it will move right. You want to move right, it will move left. Mirror image means the reverse vision. So once the telescope and instrument go opposite to each other, your instrument will behave completely reverse, because your reflex is that you are moving right, but it will start moving left. So this is a problem of the optics. This is not your problem. Problem of the optics. And to understand it, I have to demonstrate you in the lab. So that, and not only this, all the port position for every surgery, practically I will demonstrate you in the dummy. Then only it will be 100% you can understand. So in the theory, you have got some idea, but practically once I will demonstrate you, you will always remember it. So thank you very much. Please have your lunch and then we will start the extra corporate. Okay.